As usual for hymn 883, we'll sing the first three verses at the beginning and the last two at the end. Number 883. Can I invite you please to stand? Welcome to our celebration of Mass today, second Sunday of Advent. We begin lighting the second candle of our wreath, praying that the evergreens in these dark winter days may give us hope of new life, and the increasing light of the wreath itself remind us to pray with expectation for the light of the world. Lord our God, we give you praise for your Son, Christ Jesus. He is Emmanuel, God with us, the hope of people. He is the wisdom that teaches and guides, the Saviour of every nation. Let your blessings come upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May its light, its life, give us new hope in these dark winter days. It is a sign of Christ's promise to come with salvation. May he come quickly and not delay. Our prayer we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome to our celebration of Mass. Welcome if you join us online. The scriptures continue the theme, another Advent virtue, another choice in life appropriate to the season. Last week was about readiness, preparedness, alertness. This week, well, an invitation to consider what effect we have on the lives of each other, whether we choose positive or negative. Let me begin by asking you to join me in praying for the repose of the soul of Margaret Strang, who died in the hospice yesterday. She was a very faithful member of this parish community for very many years, and I know you've been remembering her in prayer, but she died yesterday. To celebrate together worthily, we call to mind our sins and we ask God's pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary of our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie
eleison. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder us, we who set out in haste to meet your Son. And may our learning of his heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Console my people, console them, says your God. Speak to the heart of Jerusalem and call to her that her time of service is ended, that her sin is atoned for, that she has received from the hand of the Lord double punishment for all her crimes. A voice cries, prepare in the wilderness a way for the Lord. Make a straight highway for our God across the desert. Let every valley be filled in, every mountain and hill be laid low. Let every cliff become a plain, and the ridges a valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all mankind shall see it, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up on a high mountain, joyful messenger to Zion. Shout with a loud voice, joyful messenger to Jerusalem. Shout without fear, say the towns of Judah. Here is your God. Here is the Lord coming with power, his arm subduing all things to him. The prize of his victory is with him. His trophies all go before him. He is like a shepherd feeding his flock, gathering lambs in his arms, holding them against his breast, and leading to their rest the mother ewes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and give us your saving help. Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and give us your saving help. I will hear what the Lord God has to say. A voice that speaks of peace. His help is near for those who fear him, and his glory will dwell in our land. Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and give us your saving help. Justice and peace have embraced. Faithfulness shall spring from the earth, and justice look down from heaven. Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and give us your saving help. The Lord will make us prosper, and our earth shall yield its fruit. Justice shall march before him, and peace shall follow his steps. Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and give us your saving help.
A reading from the second letter of St. Peter. There is one thing, my friends, that you must never forget, that with the Lord, a day can mean 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is like a day. The Lord is not being slow to carry out his promises, as anybody else might be called slow, but he is being patient with you, wanting nobody to be lost and everybody to be brought to change his ways. The day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then, with a roar, the sky will vanish. The elements will catch fire and fall apart. The earth and all that it contains will be burnt up. Since everything is coming to an end like this, you should be living holy and saintly lives while you wait and long for the day of God to come, when the sky will dissolve in flames and the elements melt in the heat. What we are waiting for is what he promised, the new heaven and the new earth, the place where righteousness will be at home. So then, my friends, while you are waiting, do your best to live lives without spot or stain, so that he will find you at peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. Prepare a way for the Lord and make his path straight, and all mankind shall see the salvation of our God. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. The beginning of the good news about Jesus Christ, the Son of God. It is written in the book of the prophet Isaiah, "Look, I'm going to send my messenger before you. He will prepare your way." A voice cries in the wilderness, "Prepare a way for the Lord, make his paths straight." And so it was that John the Baptist appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. All Judea, all the people of Jerusalem made their way to him, and they were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. John wore a garment of camel skin, and he lived on locusts and wild honey. In the course of his preaching, he said, "Someone is following me, someone who is more powerful than I am, and I am not fit to kneel down and undo the strap of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The
the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I think every family has a person in it who wants to make any family event about them. It's a kind of mark, I think, of families, extended or otherwise, that sometimes there's a person who thinks that they are what the gathering's about, what the party's for, what the event is. And it doesn't matter whose birthday it is, or whose anniversary it is, or whose baptism it is, or indeed whose funeral it is, they feel the need to somehow put themselves in the limelight and to manage it as if it were entirely for them and indeed by them. And while it starts out, I think, quite comical, it probably gets quite irritating if you've gone to the trouble of organising something or you're celebrating a significant event. And the member of the family who does this does it true to form. It's an interesting and observable phenomenon, and it's noteworthy. What I like and I find noteworthy today is that John the Baptist is exactly the opposite. He's an extraordinary figure in the life of Jesus, extraordinary figure in history, actually. You may recall that when Paul goes on his travels around what is modern-day Turkey, he meets a group of people. And when Paul tells them about Jesus, they said, oh, we've been baptized with the baptism of John the Baptist, but we haven't heard anything about this Jesus. He clearly was very influential in the ancient world, clearly was well-known, and clearly had his followers. He's extraordinarily successful in what he does. All Judea and Jerusalem go to see him. And he's a powerful religious figure in the life of Jesus also. Very influential, affirms him, encourages him, and indeed goes before him, makes him known when at last he came. And then, self-effacing, he bows out of the equation. And he wasn't, as far as we know, a religious leader. He wasn't elected to any office. He didn't have a large group following him that is identifiable other than all the people. And yet, he's tremendously powerful, tremendously influential. And I wonder if it's his ability to offer people empowerment and to stand aside while they exercise their power that makes him so attractive. I think it's a great ability to encourage people, to empower them so that they then take the initiative for themselves. And we all know how we can lack confidence in certain situations and how good it is if people build us up, if they remind us of our qualities, if they tell us what we're good at rather than knock us down, which is, of course, sometimes the default position of those who are insecure in themselves, and the best way they can manage to feel better about themselves is to make everybody else feel worse about themselves. So that ability to empower, to encourage, to build is an extraordinary one. And I think he's a very, very good example of it. And I wonder if that's why he was so powerful in the life of Jesus and so powerful an influence in the ancient world. I wonder if that could be for us his legacy. We're not followers of John the Baptist. We recognize his influence. We recognize that he spoke about the Lord Jesus as the one sent by God. We recognize that he made the Lord's paths straight and enabled and empowered him to, even unto baptism. And so we recognize his power, his influence, and his goodness. But we recognize also that what he sought to do was to say to people, and we'll hear more of this next week, here's how you can take the initiative. Here's how you can be the most powerful, useful, and good presence in your own life and then in the lives of others. And if we reflect on those whose company we enjoy? Are they not the people who build us, the people who encourage us, the people who remind us what our abilities and talents are when we doubt them for ourselves, as so often we do? Because often discouragement is what we encounter initially, as opposed to encouragement. Often we are knocked down rather than built up. And if we reflect upon our own experience, then perhaps we could build on that, and we can be those who build others. Because when we do that for others, we recognise our ability, our strength, our talent to do so. So it's one of those situations where everybody gains rather than everybody losing, which is all too often our experience of situations of difficult relationship. So to be, as he was, a faithful servant, but above all, someone who built, someone who encouraged, and someone who empowered, that we might be followers of his example, as we sought to heed the Advent virtue of readiness and preparedness last week, the Advent virtue this week is to build, to encourage, to sustain, and to empower. For such influence and power in our own lives, used for the good of others, for each other and ourselves, we pray today. To profess together our faith, we stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We make known our needs and our prayers before God.
Let the Church give thanks and praise for the good news of salvation and receive the power to proclaim to the world. May all Christian people prepare in humility and love to celebrate the coming of Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Grant to the whole world the knowledge of divine mercy revealed in Jesus Christ, that all people may come through repentance to new life. Make straight the crooked ways of the world and give light to the dark places. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Give grace to be messengers of the good news to those whose lives come near to our own. Send the healing power of the Holy Spirit to guide all in our community into the way of peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Have mercy on all who are held in the power of unrepented sin and lead them back into the right way. Strengthen those who suffer indifference and hostility as they preach the word of God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We give thanks for those who in this world received the word of salvation, showed its power in their lives, and are now at rest. Keep us faithful in the way where they have gone before until we come to the kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. To these our general intercessions, we add prayer for our own particular and local needs. We remember those who need our prayers, those in particular need, and those who have asked us to pray for them. Pray for those who join us on the live stream, particularly if they are unwell or are caring for others. We pray for ourselves and for each other, that we can be a presence that encourages and that builds in the lives of those that we meet, and so reap the benefit of that positive influence in the lives of others, which will be reflected. And we pray for those who have died, those who have died recently, Eileen Tutty and Margaret Strang in particular, and those whose anniversaries occur about now, especially those we've been asked to remember in prayer. May they all know the presence of Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
God our Father, you call us to be your people and to prepare the way of your Son, making his paths straight. Guide us to do so each day, we pray, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Stand and pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our prayers and offerings, and since we have no merit to plead our own cause, come, we pray, to our rescue by the protection of your mercy. Our prayer we make through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ Jesus our Lord.
for he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of our human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, opening for us the way to eternal salvation, so that when he comes again in glory and in power, and all is at last made known, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which we now dare to hope. And so, with angels, with the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as together with all the saints, without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us,
save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, and all who minister in your church. Remember also our brothers and sisters fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, St. Joseph, our spouse, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to life eternal, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
We pray for the coming of God's kingdom in the words the Lord Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. All the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my own peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let's stand to pray. Replenished by this spiritual food, we ask you, Lord, that by our partaking of these mysteries, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and to hold fast to the things of heaven. Our prayer we make through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you for your presence today. Thank you for joining us online. Can I ask you to familiarize yourself with the latest notices, either by the bulletin, Facebook, or the website. Thank you for your ongoing generosity to our food parcels and for your extraordinary generosity to our giving tree. It's overwhelming, and I'm sure many parents and families will be rejoicing to be able to celebrate a Christmas in the traditional fashion together. I'll suggest that we draw that to a conclusion next Sunday, because that gives us a couple of days to get the presents to the parents to reassure them so that they're not worried the last few days before Christmas. And similarly, if you know a family that would be supported or helped or will be brought to joy by having presents, please let me know and we'll get them to them as best we can in good time. We prayed together particularly for Eileen Tutty and for Margaret Strang. The details of their funerals, Eileen's is in the bulletin and Margaret's to be arranged. Please remember them and their families in your prayer. There's tea and coffee in the hall. You'd be very welcome if you come along. Hope you have a nice day today and a good week ahead. And we ask God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in with our final hymn, number 883, verses 4 and 5. Number 883.
Thank you.